Right, my first proper editing video. This image you have probably seen in my video where I photograph others. My intention with these videos is that I will pick an image where I think where the post-processing is most interesting. Well, there's quite a bit of editing here in regards to color. I also removed the shadow, so I think this video is interesting to have a look what I did over there. Okay, I'm going to my photo editing program. I use Affinity Photo. I'm not using Photoshop, but when you see the tools, it's probably all, it's all clear enough. It's not that hugely different from Photoshop. Right, I already did a wall to the wall conversion, so I didn't do really anything special to it. I'm going to zoom in. I'm not going to crop. I always do that all the way in the end, because that gives me all the freedom later to make a square crop or to make a 3x2 or to make a 4x3. Then I have all options still open. Right. First thing I want to do is duplicate this layer, because I want to make the eyes. The focal point was spot on in the field. If you take a close look, the eye is in focus and then it gets blurred towards the background, and also the nose is out of focus. But I want even more sharpness in that eye. As you probably guessed from my previous video, I like to use Topaz Sharpen for that. With this update, I find it harder to use the auto settings. So I have to click auto, do an update, and then I will just click cancel and then select manual, and then you see it updated. So now I can start from what the program thinks still needs work. I will zoom into the eye, because that's the part I want to be sure that I do it properly. Quickly, if you haven't seen my Topaz Sharpen video, I think the sharpen method I don't really like. I can use the normal sharpen in Affinity Photo. Then focus, I don't really like the output either. I somehow always like to use stabilize. That gives the most impressive results. So it sounds a bit, doesn't sound logic, but that's how I do things. Right, okay, let's just update this. Updating is pretty fast. There we go, 70%, 80%, 90%, and I can see what it will do. It really did the eye nice. It will leave the, I think it introduces just a tad too much noise. I will increase the suppressed noise a little bit, and I think I want to decrease the sharpen a little bit. Okay, let's see what it will do right now. Generating the preview usually goes quite quickly. Yeah. Okay, I'm happy with this. Okay, I will hit apply. That will go. That will take a lot more time. So I will just hit pause. Then you don't have to see the progress scroll up. Yeah. See you in a bit. Right, we are back in Affinity. As you can see, I will turn the layer with Topaz Sharpen off, and I will turn it on again. I can actually zoom in a little also. Turn off and on, you see it did a lot. It really creates a lot of contrast between the yeah, out of focus and in focus area. So that will really help to pop out the eye in a moment. But actually, what I do want to do, if you see here, all this yeah, these highlights have been sharpened a little bit as well. So that's something I do not want. I will add a mask layer to. Let's go up. Here we go. I will give this layer a name, sharpen, and I will. I will paint back in using white. The parts I want sharpened. And it was here below the. Usually take a very soft brush. And the with the low opacity, I have the opacity to 24 now, that will, yeah. So it will give nice round edges. All right, that will end about here. Right. Zoom out a little. If we turn it off and on, you see it will only. That looks really nice. Okay, I have my list with all the edits next to the screen. We did the sharpening of with Topo Sharpen. Right. As the image becomes a really abstract image, I think, in my opinion, it helps if we really let the eye pop out. So I do not want to do edits that will, yeah, look unnatural. But in this case, yeah, I really want to lift the eye a tad. So the, here we go, something like this. So the eye will really pop out in a moment. Okay. In Affinity Photo, using the red eye layer selected, I will fill it with black. That will undo the effect everywhere. And then with white, I can paint back in the saturation that I just did. Okay, I might have gone a little too much out of the lines. Pressing X, I can remove it a little again over here, right. And I think the eye just could use a little bit brightness as well. So I'll add just that exposure to it, something like that. Same thing, I will paint it black. Switch colors. I can use a little bit over here, but not too much. Mostly it's about here. Let's see if I. Yeah, that's it. And the. Yeah, that makes all the difference, right? That looks really good. Okay. Exposure. Right. If you've seen the vlog where I'll link it at the end. So if you haven't seen the vlog where I photographed these edits, but if you did, you know it was really busy. There were all kinds of grasses and there were plants and yeah. That resulted in a shadow that you can see here as well. I don't like that shadow. It takes away too much attention. So I want to remove that, in this case I only had to use the curves tool and I up the blacks quite a bit. The remove of the shadow, then I know what it is. Again, I will remove the entire effect and then I will paint it back in. Opacity, yeah, I want the hardness to be really low, just a little bit bigger. Bigger over here, opacity even lower because it's not really. It's a little bit over here. Might have to add a little bit more. Increase the curve a little bit more because I think the it's all still a bit too dark to my taste. In this case I only use the curves tool to remove the shadow. That okay, yeah, sometimes that's all what's needed. Sometimes also the shadows can have a slightly different color, then you also need to do some other editing. But in this case, I only use the curves tool. I have to up. It's something like this is. Yeah. Okay. It's just a tiny bit. I think for our purposes to right now this looks okay. What I only probably want to do is over here it's a little bit too much, so I'll decrease the opacity a little, up the hardness. I have back selected, so I'm going to with a very low opacity remove the effect again a little bit by painting in a little bit black white. I think for right now I do not want to take this that it will take too long right now, but you get the idea. Okay, there is some green up here and here, and I think that really distracts attention away from the image. I want that removed, so I'm going to add a weird thing with green is that often you would think you need to select the greens to remove the greens, but as you see nothing is really happening over here. With green you usually have to start using the yellow. If I now decrease, you see all the greens also over here and here and below here, they are controlled by yellow. Well, I think this looks okay. Again, it affects the snake as well. That's something I do not want. So I'm going to remove the effect altogether. And I'm going to paint it in using a small brush. Going to up the opacity a little bit. Okay. And just paint in. Well, this is probably not showing in the final photo, but still I want to. There's a little bit of green cast over here. Right. I'll leave it for here right now, because in the final crop that I have in mind, the other greens are not affected, so that's all okay. Right. I do want to have the focus in the end in this area. So normally what you, the focus, the attention of the viewer. So what you would normally do is add a vignette to draw the viewer into the photo. With the standard vignette tool, it doesn't really work because, it will only do the edges evenly of the whole image. And I want to do it over here, the vignette to the area around the head. So I will do this differently. I will make a paint layer. I will call that vignette. I will fill the entire layer with black. And then I'm going to use the erase brush. And I usually then set it quite big with a low opacity. Hardness can be a little bit higher. And then I'm going to just push a little bit over here. Maybe make it smaller degrees so I can add a little bit detail here as well. I think this pretty much is what I want. Then I'm going to it's about here. And the head, of course, I want to be right. This I don't like. It's a little bit too much. Vignette removed, so I'm going to paint in a little bit. Okay, that looks quite good. I think actually the head could use a little bit more oomph. So I will add a little bit exposure in the head. I will just... The trick with editing is what I try to do is not make it look unnatural, so you only want to add little tiny bits. The trick that I use to prevent the trick that I use too much is that usually I make these edits and then I return after a cup of coffee or even the next day and then have a look, and then some things you think, that's too much, and then I will move that. It's the urge to share an image right away after editing, that's something I learned the hard way. You really have to have some patience to share the image tomorrow, and that will only help prevent errors or overdoing in the effect. Right. Almost every image can use some brightness and contrast. This is really adding, a little bit more brightness, or maybe actually decrease. No, just a tiny bit more brightness. A little bit more contrast, not too much. Right. You can see that the head of the snake now really has a lot of contrast, while the rest of the body is more muted. It's both muted in exposure, so it's a little bit darker. It's also muted in color. It has less so the head is really popping out. That's what I want to do. Right. What I see right now is this stick is also causing a shadow and the stick, and it just enters the crop. So I want to remove that because it would take up a lot of attention from the viewer. I'm using the inpainting tool for that. I do this really quickly. If someone who's really into snakes, they will probably see that added right away. So I probably would want to spend more time on it. But for this instance, it's... right, like I said before, normally I will just... Yeah, I always do the cropping all the way in the end, because that gives me the all the options I still want to do later. I can make a square crop, or I can make a 3x2, or I can make a 4x3. Yeah, I can do a portrait or a landscape. So at this point, I would normally save the image. I don't have to do that right now, because yeah, the wheel edit has already been done a while ago. I want to make a 3x2 crop right now to end this video. Right, let's see. I probably do not want to have too much of this. That will probably take away, yeah, something like this. It's quite a crop from A7. If I had a A7R, the A7R3 or the R4, yeah, I would still have a lot of resolution to play with. But in this case, for social media, this would really look nice. Well, I'll probably want to make a few small adjustments to the vignette. I will add a little bit more here. A little bit more here. I want to skip the shadow part. I see that's still dark over here, and I probably want to add just a tiny bit over here. Right. I think that's a pretty accurate reproduction of all the edits that I did. I hope you like this video. If you have some questions or comments, yeah, please add them below. Also, if you like this video, because if you do, yeah, I can add more videos like this, maybe one from every vlog. If there's an image that I think I did some edits that I, yeah, would be interesting for you to see how I did those, I can make more videos like this. Please add a like if you like this video. If you want to see more like this, a few more videos, and you haven't subscribed yet, please consider subscribing. Do not forget to hit the notification bell, and then I will see you again in my next video. Bye bye.